Good morning, everyone. So we are going to learn about Thevenin theorem. It is also called Thevenin's theorem in the network analysis. This is the statement of your Thevenin theorem. Thevenin theorem was given by a French telegraph engineer, Léon Thevenin. On his name, this theorem has been named. This is very, very widely used theorem in any of your electrical subject. Why? One may ask this question, why it is widely used, sir? Because it tends to simplify any kind of complicated circuits to you. The statement is, for any linear active bilateral complicated network across its load terminals can be replaced by single voltage source and one series impedance. The condition is the circuit on which we are going to apply Thevenin theorem to simplify from its complexity to simplify the circuit to get response across a specified element that could be termed as load terminal. So it should be linear, it should be active bilateral network. Then only we can apply this Thevenin's theorem. Let me repeat the statement once again. For any linear active bilateral complicated network across its load terminals can be replaced by single voltage source and one series impedance. Below is the diagram given. See this. This is your network. This is a kind of network given to you. It is your linear, active and bilateral circuits given to you, complicated circuit given to you, and across this there is load connected. Across this there is a load connected L, and we want to know the response across this load L. Now, the idea given by Thevenin's theorem is this whole complicated circuit can be simplified by using a single voltage source. This is a single voltage source up with one series impedance. Now the position of load is here. Now, this is your load. Let us understand what is actually ZTH and VTH. ZTH or VTH is given here, where VTH is your Thevenin's equivalent voltage. We'll understand how it is calculated, where it is calculated, what are the means to calculate Thevenin's equivalent voltage. Likewise, ZTH, it is your Thevenin's equivalent impedance with respect to load terminals, or as seen from the load terminals, with all sources replaced by their internal impedances. This is very important. Dear friends, dear students, please mark this once again and listen it carefully once again. While we are calculating, while we are observing ZTH, Thevenin's equivalent impedance, from the load terminals where we have been asked to calculate the response, with respect to that load terminals, we are seeing ZTH, and while calculating ZTH, all other sources, all sources present in that particular circuit will be replaced by their internal impedances, internal resistances This is also known as driving point impedance at load terminals AB. I have included this point because this is a very high frequently questions asked during interview examinations. People love to ask these questions. Where do you calculate driving point impedance in your network theorem, in Thevenin's theorem? Okay. Now let us go back to our first diagram where we are having your separated load. Now what we are going, we are connecting this load. We are connecting this load to here and connecting this load to here. So it is connected. Now if it is connected, so what will be load current? What will be load current? The load current will be, the load current will be IL, that is load current IL is equal to, in short IL, will be VTH upon ZTH plus ZL. This is your ZL. This is your ZL. This is your ZTH and this is your Thevenin voltage. This is also known as open circuit voltage. The open circuit voltage from where the load has been opened. Okay, this is particularly basically Thevenin voltage, but while calculations we may use the term open circuit voltage in the application of Thevenin's theorem. This is your whole idea of application of Thevenin's theorem. This gives you the formula. The load current across the terminal AB is calculated as IL is equal to VTH upon ZTH plus ZL. Now let us move towards advantages of Thevenin's theorem, which is very important as far as your network analysis subject is concerned from exam point of view. It is actually asked in several examinations, several interview questions. So the advantages is advantages of Thevenin's theorem. The first point is, please listen it very carefully. It is used to convert multi-source, multi-loop and multi-node networks to very simple network having one source and one impedance. Having one source and one impedance, and initially it was having multi-source, multi-loop and multi-node. This multi-source, multi-loop and multi-node has made the circuit complex. You can imagine if it is so many nodes available, so many loops and so many sources available in a network circuit, and we have been asked to calculate response across any of the element present in that particular circuit, then it will require a lot of hard work to solve. Although it is possible to find out the solution, it is very much possible to find out the solution of this complex circuit, but it will require a lot of labor and it will require a lot of calculations and time, and also in this fast world we need quick solution. So This theorem came in year 1883. This theorem came in the year 1883 by the Leon Thevenin. Okay. Now it is today it is very much used. Second point, second advantage is if there is single non-linear element in any circuit, then it can be considered as a load. Considered as load and can be removed from the circuit. From the circuit. Now what happens next? The rest circuit can be converted into Thevenin equivalent circuit. What happens next? The rest of the circuit can be converted into Thevenin's circuit. In this way, what Thevenin theorem is doing? Thevenin theorem is separating linear elements to non-linear elements. From its non-linear elements if it is present in the circuit. Okay, understand this point very clearly. A circuit is having lots of elements. It may have linear or it may have non-linear. In the statement, please remember what we have studied. For any linear active bilateral, it should be linear element present. What happens for non-linear elements if it is present in the circuit? The solution is given by point number 2. If single non-linear element in any circuit is present, that can be considered as load. And remember what is happening to a load in Thevenin theorem. We are separating the load from the rest of the circuit. And the rest of the circuit is having only linear, so that can be very much easily converted into Thevenin circuit. What is Thevenin circuit? Just have a look at this. This is your Thevenin circuit where we are having VTH, we are having ZTH and we are having an open terminal here where load is to be connected. Just have a look here. See this. This was initially open. This was initially open and load has been inserted into to complete the circuit, to have the formula I load is equal to VTH upon ZTH. Now the load has been inserted to Z load. This gives you load current with the application of Thevenin's theorem. This is so simple as it is. Now, let us move towards to understand the next advantages offered by Thevenin's theorem, which is All right. This is your Thevenin's theorem. We have been discussing Thevenin's theorem since the last video, since the last slide. And we have discussed its statement. We have discussed its working. And we were discussing how it is actually giving plus edge or advantages to network solving ability. We have discussed that it tend to simplify the complex circuit into a simple one, having open circuit voltage or Thevenin voltage with series Thevenin impedance or Thevenin resistance. And we have seen that if non-linear element is present in that circuit, that non-linear element can be considered as a load, and that load be thrown out of the circuit for the last considerations, and thus it separates the non-linear elements from its linear elements, and the rest of the circuit, after removing the non-linear, after removing the non-linear elements, the rest of the circuit is having linear circuits, linear elements only, that could be very much easily converted into Thevenin circuit, having VTH and in series ZTH. And the last one was, whenever we are using maximum power transfer theorem, just listen it, whenever we are using maximum power transfer theorem, we have to first convert it into Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Okay. After the statement, after the working, after the advantages of Thevenin's theorem, we are actually going to understand it and apply the understanding of Thevenin's theorem into a numerical. A circuit is given to you like this. This is your voltage source, 10 angle 0 degree voltage source. And by using Thevenin's theorem, we have been asked to find power in, 1 ohm resistor connected to the terminals AB. It means what? From the terminal AB, 1 ohm resistor is connected. This is your R load. We have separated this R load from rest of the circuit, and we have to apply Thevenin's theorem. We have to apply Thevenin's theorem from this part. Okay, so let's start. We have learned so many things about the Thevenin's theorem, and we are going to understand by doing it. First step is, if RL was connected into the circuit, load resistor was connected into the circuit, then remove the load resistance. But in the case here, load is actually not connected. It is given in the questions. 1 ohm resistor is connected across terminal A and B. Okay, so keep in mind that in the last, we have to connect load 1 ohm resistor. So, this is our open. This is your open. From this, we have to calculate open circuit voltage, VOC, open circuit voltage, or VTH. Or in this particular circuit, we are going to call it VAB. VAB. Okay. So, what I mean to say that whether it is VAB, it is equal to VOC, ultimately equal to VTH here. So don't get confused. Thevenin voltage is your open circuit voltage, and here open circuit voltage where we have opened at the terminal AB. So across the terminal AB, we are going to calculate the voltage. Now, apply KVL. This is your closed loop. This is a closed loop, so apply KVL in this loop. Okay, let's consider there is a current flowing in this loop. Current is I, capital I current. Now what we are going to do, this is given to you, plus minus is given to you. the term, the polarity of voltage is always given to you. Okay. So, as per the direction of current we have chosen, just give it a sign convention. This will be plus, this will be minus. The entry is plus, this will be minus. The entry is plus, the exit is minus. Okay. After application of KVL into this loop, the current I will be from where we are getting this? We are getting this from KVL. I will be equal to, in this loop, I will be equal to 10 angle 0 degree voltage upon the resistance of the path of this current flowing circuit. What are the resistances? This is 2 ohm minus J2 ohm plus J2 ohm. Okay. So 2 ohm minus J2 ohm plus J2 ohm. This is from the capacitance, this is from the inductor. Okay. From the diagram above. So this gets cancelled out, minus J2 plus J2 remains only 2. So it is 10 angle 0 degree upon 2. So it is 5 angle 0 degree ampere. Okay. This is open. Across the terminal AB, we are going to find VTH. We have discussed this, so keep in mind. Okay, we have calculated I. Why we are calculating I here? Because we want to know what is the current flowing across this inductor of ohmic value J2 ohm. If we are able to, or if also if we know the value of I flowing through this, so we are reaching towards to calculate VTH. So we have actually find out that current value across this inductor J2 ohm is 5 angle 0 degree ampere in polar form. So let us calculate here only. VTH is equal to VAB, that is equal to drop across J2, that is drop across J2 ohm, which is equal to, how do we calculate drop? Drop means voltage drop. V is equal to I into R. We have calculated I here and R is given to you. R means the ohmic value is given to you. So it is I into J2 volt. That is VTH is equal to I into J2 volt. So VTH is equal to put the value of 5 angle 0 degree. Okay, this is actually 5 angle 0 degree is actually 5. So it will be your 10 J volt. Okay, now if VTH is equal to J 10 volt, so it can be written as 10 angle 90 degree volt. Why? This is a purely complex number J10, so the complex number is actually on the y axis, that is on the 90 degree axis. That is, let's have a quick look. VTH is equal to having I into J2. I value is 5 angle 0 degree into J2. This is in volt. 5 angle 0 degree can be written as 582J2. So it is 10J. It is purely a complex number. It means what? Purely complex number. It has no real part. It is existing on the y axis, j axis only. So it could be written as 10 angle 90 degree. This is a 90 degree. So VTH is 10 angle 90 degree volt. This is your VTH or VAB or voltage of open circuit. Say what you want to say. Now we are interested to find out Z equivalent, which is your ZTH, Thevenin impedance. While calculating Thevenin impedance, what we do? We do that all the sources must be replaced by their internal resistances or internal impedances. Okay, so let me draw the circuit once again. This is a circuit. Let's have a quick look. This is a circuit. While calculating ZTH from here, why we are calculating from here? Because here was the position of load resistance. So with respect to this position AB, we are seeing this circuit. While calculating ZTH, we will replace whatever the sources present in the circuit. So here only one source is present in the circuit, which is 10 angle 0 degree volt. Voltage source must be short circuited. So we are going to short circuit the voltage source. So the circuit will be like this. Short circuited voltage source. This is 3 ohm. This is 2 ohm. This is minus J 2 ohm. This is plus J 2 ohm. This is 3 ohm, and this is your minus J 5 ohm given. We are seeing to calculate ZTH from here. We are watching the circuit from here. So how it will behave? The circuit will behave from here like this. Will be in parallel. The element here will be in parallel. Okay. So it is like 2 minus J2. These two are in series. Okay, so we have added this with the sign, and this series is in parallel with J2. So parallel J2. This is Z here, so it will be like this. Still we are having to calculate ZTH. We are in the process. This is this circuit. This is 3 ohm and this is minus J 5 ohm. Okay, so this all impedances and resistances are coming in series connections. Just have a look. So just add this with the formula known. What is Z here? Z is equal to 2 minus J2 into J2 upon 2 minus J2. So we are calculating Z here. Z is equal to, which is the parallel combination of 2 minus Z2 and J2. So it is 2 minus Z2 into J2 upon 2 minus Z2 minus this is plus J2. So it is two J minus J square into 2, which is equal to 2 plus J 2 as minus J square is equal to 1. And here it gets cancelled out. Minus J2 plus J2 is equal to, gets cancelled out. This is cancelled out. You remain 2. Okay. Remain 2. So the Z value is this one. 2 plus J2. Now Z equivalent will be equal to, see this, Z equivalent will be equal to this plus this plus this. So calculate here, ZTH is equal to 3 minus J5 plus the value of Z, the value of Z from here. Okay, so it is ZTH finally equal to 3 minus J5 plus 2 plus J2. It is J2. Okay. So ZTH is equal to 5 minus J3 ohm. Now we have known ZTH and VTH. VTH was also calculated in the previous slide. See this? VTH we have calculated. With the use of VTH and ZTH, what we are going to draw? We are going to draw Thevenin equivalent circuit. We are going to draw Thevenin's equivalent circuit, which is this is your VTH, and in series with the VTH it is your ZTH. This is your terminal AB, this is your terminal AB, across which a load resistor of 1 ohm was connected. So now connect this in the Thevenin's equivalent circuit. It will be like this. VTH is 10 angle 90 degree volt, and ZTH equivalent Thevenin impedance is 5 minus J 3 ohm. So to calculate load resistance IL, which is like this, IL will flow across this load. IL will be equal to, from the formula, VTH upon ZTH plus R load. So let us calculate. Put the value of VTH. VTH value is your, IL is equal to, VTH value is your 10 angle 90 degree upon ZTH value put 5 minus J3 plus resistance value is 1. R load is your RE1, which is pure number, which is real number 1. So it is 10 angle 90 degree upon, convert this rectangular format into polar format, that is 6.708. I have calculated, I have converted this rectangular format into polar form with the help of calculator, which is coming 6.708 angle minus 26.56 degree. So it is 1.4907 angle 116.56 degree. Current is in ampere. Therefore we have calculated IL, which is 1.4907 116.56 degree ampere. Now power across this 1 ohm resistor will be IL square into R. R value is 1 ohm. So it is 1.4907 whole square into 1, which is 2.22 watt. This is the complete solutions, which was to find the power across 1 ohm resistor, by using Thevenin's theorem. We have understood it very properly, right from the definition, the statement, by the procedure of applying Thevenin's theorem, with the advantages, with the working hand, by taking a very suitable example. This is your university questions. This was asked in university question. This is very good example, and we have solved it very properly to understand. First, we have seen that load resistor to be separated from the rest of the circuit. If it is attached in the initial circuit, it has to be separated. Or likewise, in this circuit, the load resistor was actually separated and was told to you that it is AB terminal. From where the load has been separated, we have to calculate two things. What two things? One is your VTH or V open circuit, or if it is VAB, first thing, and second very important thing is your ZTH. While calculating ZTH, we have to replace all the sources available in that circuit with their internal impedances or internal resistances. If it is given or if it is not given, please consider the internal resistances or internal impedances of the sources as of ideal one. Okay, and after calculating ZTH and VTH, construct this Thevenin's equivalent circuit, which is actually VTH in series with your ZTH, and connect the separated load 1. This is the separated load 1 we have connected into the equivalent circuit. Now this is complete circuit. Once the load is connected into the circuit, current will start flowing. The current is your IL. We know the formula of IL is equal to VTH upon ZTH plus RL. With the help of this formula, we are going to calculate IL. Now if power dissipation has been asked to the resistor, we can very much calculate power dissipation across that load by the formula P dissipation is equal to I square or I load square into the value of that load resistor load impedance. Here the load is given 1 ohm. So I have calculated like this, and this is the complete solution. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you must have enjoyed the solutions. Thank you.